Hello everyone and welcome back, guys, to more iRacing. It's Ferrari GT3 Sprint Time once again, and we're on pole somehow by half a second here around Tsukuba, which isn't bad for a 55 second lap. I'll certainly take that one. Like always, a 15 minute race ahead of us. Quite looking forward to this. Hopefully we can have a good race, and maybe, just maybe, I think I could be on for my 10th road racing victory on iRacing. Just maybe. That is of all time, if I'm not mistaken. I think I've got 9 so far. 6 of those came in, I think, my first 7 races in the Masters.
Celsius.
We'll wait and see.
29 Celsius.
As to what we can do here today. We're sat at about 1300 iRacing. I desperately need to try and get it back up. The road 2K is certainly, hopefully, going to be happening quite soon. But yeah, we'll control the pace
the safety car
off of the start. Not too sure what this guy's trying to do. And we'll just bolt whenever I feel like. And it's green. That was the worst starting there's ever been. Didn't know if I could actually get past the safety car once he was in the pits. This guy is not going to dive it up the inside. It's been chaos behind me. Someone's gone over. Holy moly. And I've got a 2.5 second gap. Okay, we'll take it, I guess. Hopefully there's a good thumbnail in there. But I mean, yeah, unfortunately where we were kind of rocked in the Formula Renault race, F1 2019's dropped. I'm spending a lot of time on there. It's probably going to be a bit less iRacing content at the moment, but I have got a couple of set of Corsa races as well that I need to upload. But yeah, I mean, F1 2019's kind of taken over at the moment, but I want to try and find the time to do some iRacing on the side.
The gap behind is now 2.3.
But yeah, that's been a good opening lap. It's probably going to be, what, 18, 19 laps? I've got to be honest, this is about as quick a car you want to take around Tsukuba. It is not ideal in something like this. Especially with the way the Ferrari likes to have a bit of understeer and oversteer. But yeah, we'll just try and build on the advantage, see what we can do.
Okay, Matt.
Can you crawl up the curve?
Behind has just done a 53.
Fair bit of awareness from the guy in the pits. I don't want to do that. Just pinch the fronts on the way in. Is that the guy that was P2 on the grid? That's just about the pits, I don't know. I mean, if qualifying times are anything to go by, there could be a couple of people that we end up lapping. I think it's an 18-car grid, there or thereabouts. Most people are sort of in the high 53s. Understeer. Oh, come on. I'd love a 0X race as well. That'd probably be quite useful with my SR at where it's at the moment. I think we're sat at about 2.2 SR. You've got to try and make sure you keep the car straight into that braking zone, because you are going to clip a couple of curves on the entry. Yeah, this Ferrari, like a lot of cars with ABS, you want to keep it pointing in arrows straight into the braking zones. Otherwise it gets very unhappy very quickly.
Sector 2.
So 53.3 then. I'll take that.
behind. The gap's now 3.1.
It's weird that the back end likes to get a little bit loose through there. It's very, very strange. Because it's not exactly a hard corner, but I guess just with the traction control, the power tries to cut out for a moment, and then you just get a huge amount of wash on the rear end, just trying to skate around. This thing probably wouldn't be much different.
Matt, just keep hitting your marks.
Well,
this
effectively,
the quickest
well,
right
no,
now. The lap time was at 53.39.
Yeah, if this thing had no traction control, it would probably be quicker around here, I would have thought, even for someone like me. ABS is nice, though.
Yellow flag, keep your wits about you, mate.
Someone's had an incident.
You've got 10 minutes left. 10 minutes to go.
So over that little crest, halfway through the corner, it likes to get a little bit leery. We are building up an advantage, though. Make sure you take it. I reckon the late apex is the way to go through there. Could try and keep it pinned on the inside curve, but I just don't think it's worth it. That's not ideal. Holy moly.
That was 53.26.
And we were because of that we were a tenth up going into T1. That was almost a big moment. I don't think I would have saved that a couple of months ago. How far are we? 9 minutes to go. So almost half. It's amazing doing these. I love going back to these GT3 sprint races. Because you're finally starting to settle into a rhythm and you realise you've got, what, 5 laps to go normally around a proper track.
We're quickest at the moment. That was 53.38. Sector one time is good.
I'm trying to just push the car a bit, see what I can get out of it. Finally starting to find a way to get through that kink as well without unsettling the rear end. Oh, my braking marker into that corner's gone now because of the sun. That's not ideal. There's about to be a thunderstorm in Sakura. Come on, late apex. Beautiful.
Okay, Matt, that's good consistency. Keep it up.
How have we dropped a tenth through there?
Halfway home. Fuel looks good.
Surely I'm not the only person that gets that. You think you nailed something in there? Oh god, no. Ooh, that's not what I wanted to do. That was not what I wanted to do. How bad is the car damage? Well, I said about 1 lap prior. How I'd start to learn that corner, and then instantly I got to mess it up. I am iRacing noob. I always cause my own pain as well, or at least most of the time.
P3.
Oh, we are P3 still. Definitely got a little bit of damage. much, though. Definitely need to get some blue flags out here, though. No, don't do that again.
Alright, Matt. Stay close. Wait for him to make a mistake.
Oh, I thought that was the leader just in front of this car.
5 minutes to go. You're looking good for a podium.
I've definitely got a curse for getting my 10th iRacing win. That curse being I'm a noob, but still. Try and hassle this guy, but no, 5 laps.
On your left. Hold your line. Clear left. That lap time was 53.87.
Left.
He's still there. Clear left. Push, push, push. Look at your second here. Clear left.
Nice one, mate. I was trying to throw him. Didn't want to do that. Oh, he's just reversed onto the track and almost killed the other guy. Well, while Breaking Point Shadow's back, can I lap this guy? That's probably the fire lane.
The gap behind has increased to 1.0 seconds. Your lap time was 54.45.
Yeah, car's definitely damaged. Try and apply the pressure for this guy though. 3 laps. So, 17 lap race. Almost follow him into T1.
Just 2 minutes left. 2 minutes to go. Car right.
What are you doing? You're gonna give up the place, babe. I'm just trying to hang alongside me. He's chopping off the guy in front as well. Lap traffic, man. Need to start reading the iRacing handbook, I reckon.
That last lap was at 54.43.
Guy behind me's gone for it as well. Thank you. One more lap to go. We could have potentially... Yeah, I reckon we could have got us onto lap 18, yeah. It would have been tight, though. I think we would probably be about 11 seconds ahead of where we are now. No.
Okay, Matt, one more to go. Keep it together, we'll be on the podium. Sector 1 is 0.15.
Let's just bring it home, though. A little bit good, obviously I made a mistake.
Sector 3 times quick.
Hopefully we can bring over P2. I really, really want to get back in the Formula 3. That's what I want to jump back into. Don't know about the next races. Don't know where they're racing either. This guy's actually going to give up blue flags for some reason. Thanks. I mean, we lapped up to P9 in the end. Definitely have the pace to win, but not the consistency through the final corner.
Well done. Decent drive.
Well, that is the race over and done with. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this video. Get yourself subscribed if you're new around here as well and you want to see more iRacing on the channel. Yeah, that'll do us for this one, and I will see you next time, I think, for some Assetto Corsa.